Good morning, YouTube. So with today's video, I'm gonna give you my top 10 designer fragrances for the autumn of 2021. So let's just get into it. So first one's gonna be Hugo Boss Boss Bottled Intense. So this is gonna be the Eau de Parfum Concentration. This one is very similar to the original that came out in like 1998. I believe this one came out in 2015 or 2016. Maybe it might be 2017, but nonetheless, this one is thicker and bolder than the original. It smells quite similar, but just like the name that's added to it, it's just a more intense version. What you're gonna get green apple, vanilla, cinnamon, cloves, sandalwood, and so on. So it's just so very similar to the original. It smells very similar, but again, it's just thicker, bolder, and more intense, just like the name itself. This is a great fragrance where you could just dress it, like dressing down to dressing it up. It's very versatile, it's ageless, so someone who is like in their teenage years can wear it to someone who is a grandfather. So you could dress this to school, to work, to something that's daytime semi-formal, or even nighttime semi-formal. Daytime, nighttime, super versatile. Longevity off this is 8 to 10 hours. Fragrance number two, let's go to the brand of Ferrari, and this is gonna be Vetiver Essence. I used to be a big spokesperson. I was the unpaid shill for this brand. And some people said that Ferrari really should just owe me a paycheck. In all fairness and to be realistic, my platform was not big enough to really direct a lot of people towards the brand. So they didn't really make a lot of money based on my recommendations. So this one here is very different. You're gonna get lots of vetiver, coffee, hazelnut, cardamom, and pepper. So it's an earthy vetiver, gourmandy coffee with loads of spices. This is classy, it's masculine. At first, I did not like this one at all, but now I really do. This is a very, I would say it's more on the mature end of the spectrum. And I would say that this is like 30 and up. Someone who's in their teenage years will not like this at all, including maybe someone who's like college age as well. So 30 and up is great for dressing down to dressing it up, daytime, nighttime. Very, very versatile, and longevity off this is 7 to 8 hours. Fragrance number three, we're gonna go with a cheapie, and boy, this one here is really good. Perry Ellis M. This was actually one of my very first videos that I ever put out like 8 years ago, and I can't even watch this stuff back then because it's so cringy. Shit, my stuff is still cringy to this very day. But this one here gets comparisons to Chanel Allure Homme, which is super sexy. This is super sexy, but it's a much cheaper synthetic version than the Chanel itself. There's tonkabean to this one here, balsam fir, vanilla, cinnamon, and star anise. This is just a creamy, vanillic, spicy, woody kind of fragrance. It's very warm, very seductive. It does have a little bit of a classy vibe though. I find with like sexiness, you have like your kind of like your skanky sexy, like, you know, like your strip club sexy, which I'm not really into anymore because kind of grown. Then you got like your classy sexy, and you got your like confident sexy. This is classy and confidence together, yet someone who is younger can wear it with ease, including someone who's older. It's very versatile, so dressing it down to dressing it up. It is ageless, and longevity off this is 6 to 7 hours. Fragrance number four, if you want something that's boozy, but classy and playful, then the Trussardi Uomo the Red might be for you. You're gonna get cognac, nutmeg, clary sage, violet leaf, tonkabean, and a little bit of vetiver. Now, the cognac in this, I just get a boozy accord. Like, I get like a bit of a red wine kind of feel, which is kind of unusual, but there is some sweetness to it. You're gonna get that herbal clary sage, some spices, a little bit of woods towards, a little bit of leather, I should say, towards the base, but not a whole lot. This is a classy, sexy, flirty, yet masculine kind of fragrance that someone who is young to old can wear. And when I mean young, I'm thinking someone who is at college, okay? Not someone who is in high school, because this is gonna be a little bit too mature for you. If you want something that, if you are in like high school, you want something that's sweet, a little fruity, maybe a little bit fresh, This is none of that, okay? There is some sweetness to it, but it just has that boozy gentility quality to it. But it has that sexy, flirtatious vibe as well. So you could dress this down to dressing it up to like dressing down like business casual to a night out, like a date, to like a daytime or nighttime semi-formal event. This is not per se a tuxedo event, but if you're going to a wedding, this is definitely a great scent for it. Longevity is 7 to 8 hours. Fragrance number five, this one I did not like when I first smelled it like 5-6 years ago. But now, oh, awesome. Dolce & Gabbana Por Homme Intenso. With this one here, you're gonna get lavender, tobacco, basil, hay, sandalwood, cypress, and clary sage. This is just a fresh, aromatic, tobacco-y, which is not even a word, fougere fragrance that is herbal. It does smell classical, like a little bit vintage, so I'm thinking someone who's gonna be like 35 or a little bit older might appreciate this one a little bit more. Yet someone who's in their 20s, who's an older soul, can wear this with ease. This is a great signature versatile fragrance. So you could dress it down to dressing it up, daytime, nighttime. For me, this is a great office fragrance. This smells of class and of elegance. Longevity is 7 to 9 hours. Fragrance number six, unfortunately I don't have a bottle, I don't even have a decant. I do have a sample and I recently reviewed this one with my buddy Rush, and it's the latest release from Burberry, and that's gonna be Burberry Hero for Men. This stuff is really good. I was not expecting much because it's Burberry, but this is a woody, spicy kind of fragrance. You're gonna get bergamot, juniper, pepper, and three different types of cedar. I think it's Himalaya, Virginia, and I forget the other one. But this, just like the classification, which it is a woody spicy, is just a very woody, spicy kind of fragrance that has a little bit more of a mature vibe, yet someone who's in their 20s can wear it. I just find it comes across as more of a 30-year-old type of gentleman, but dressing it down to dressing it up, very versatile. On my skin, later on in the scent life, and it's probably just my skin, the fragrance does become a little bit more creamy, which is kind of strange because with Rush, he did not get that. Longevity off the sample that I had was 5 to 7 hours, yet I'm sure with a bottle, it's gonna be like at least 6 to 8 hours. Fragrance number seven, Bulgari Man in Black Cologne. This stuff, when I saw the note breakdown, I'm like, this is not something that I'm gonna like, but it's really good. You're gonna get rum or booze. There's white florals to this one here. There's amber, benzoin, tuberose, but also orange blossom. This is just a boozy, white floral, ambery kind of scent with a little bit of resins. This definitely is more of an older gentleman type of scent. So I'm thinking 35 or possibly even 40 years old. This is super classy. The white florals in this, because of the white florals, I thought, nope, definitely not gonna be for me. But the white florals, the amber and the booze, it's a very unique scent. Longevity off this is 6 to 8 hours, and it's a great versatile signature scent that's very underrated. Fragrance number eight, let's go with another mini. This is gonna be Cartier L'Envol EDP. So this one here is, this is gonna be a little bit more thicker and bolder than the original, which is an eau de toilette concentration, but there's a lot of similarities when it comes to the smell itself. You're gonna get sage, lavender, violet leaf, musk, iris, honey, and guaiac wood. So this is just a sweet, delicious, silky kind of honey with lots of woods, a little bit of iris, and musk. Ooh, this one here is really good. When I first smelled it, I'm like, okay, no, the honey and like the other notes, it's not jiving with my nose. But as I started to wear it, it's a work of art. This is, it has a mature vibe, but it also has a younger person's vibe as well. Like the sweetness in this, the honey, it does add a little bit of a classy vibe, but it adds a little bit of a playful vibe as well. So if you are a mature gentleman, a gentleman now, and I do think that this could be unisex, if it's not, a mature gentleman who knows when to be serious, but also let down and just have some fun and have that youthful side, This is a great scent. It's quite versatile, dressing it down to dressing it up. Daytime, nighttime, longevity off this is 7 to 9 hours. Fragrance number 9, Montblanc Emblem Absolute. So this is just a woody, fruity, sweet honey kind of fragrance. You're gonna get wild fruits, honey, vetiver, cardamom, pear, but also lavender. The pear and the fruity notes really pop, including that honey note. You're gonna get some lavender as well to amp up the freshness, but you're also gonna get the vetiver towards the base. And the vetiver, I believe that there's some sandalwood to this one here, but the base itself is very earthy, fantastic, but it is sweet from top to, I would say, almost the bottom. It's daytime, nighttime, young, old, very versatile. And this is quite affordable. This is like $30 or 30 to 35 bucks. Longevity off this is 7 to 8 hours. Fragrance number 10, let's go with a great John Varvatos scent. Vintage, so John Varvatos Vintage. This is vintage, classical, but modern at the same time. It's kind of like old and new. It's a great fragrance that's fresh, herbal, classy. You're gonna get rhubarb, quince, orris, tobacco, tonka bean, suede, cinnamon, and lavender. This is just, there's a reason why that this is Justin Copeland's, one of his favorite fragrances out there. And you know what? I really, truly understand. Like, this is like a 5 out of 5. This does come across as a little bit more mature, but yet someone who's in their 20s can pull it off. You just kind of have to be an older soul, kind of like this one here, the Dolce & Gabbana Intenso. But this stuff here, I find, is a little bit more easier to wear itself. Fantastic daytime, nighttime, very versatile. Longevity off this is 5 to 7 hours. So unfortunately, the longevity is not the best. 6, 7 hours, not bad. But every so often, I do get 5 hours. So everyone, that is my top 10 designer fragrances for the autumn of 2021. So any reviews that I've done from these fragrances, they will be in the description below. I would say the most cringiest fragrance to watch out there, oh shit, like I said, all my content is cringe, but this by far is like the cringiest one because I did this one back in 2013. So I said Perry Ellis M. The M stands for because that's what the lady said. Oh God, only me, I tell you. So what videos to watch next? Well, whatever pops up on all four corners. Guys, before we go, make sure to give me one of these as I really would appreciate it. I thank you for your time, take care, and I'll see you later. Thanks for watching, everyone.